So what did you do with your dress? Diana asked me this seductively, handing the man behind the counter a small pink ticket, a thin white cigarette in the other hand. After the divorce, I mean, she adds, releasing a perfect puff of white smoke. Her eyes find me amidst the cloud, a sly smile gracing her face. I donated it in Syria, I say, looking away, knowing she sought a more salacious answer. Her lips press together as she leans back against the counter, draws another hit and asks, but she wanted to do something else with it, right? I look back at her, just another wild woman beneath the picturesque princess. She plays with the pearls around her neck, moves her hand slowly down to her cleavage and waits. I wanted to burn it. She was amused, but thought it might bring better luck to another bride. She smirks. Darling, you and I both had dresses with trains long enough to sweep in every dirty secret. That's a curse no bride's body can break. It's too bad Megan isn't wearing this one. She nods her head left towards the back room, where the man had disappeared for too long, drowning somewhere beneath pounds and pounds of ivory silk taffeta and creamy chiffon. Some stains, no matter what we do, can't even fade.